Rob Machado and Taylor Steele were done filming The Drifter, the only issue that needed solving was what to do with all the bonus footage.
I always just in the back of my mind thought that one day I would probably put together something by myself and kind of take all the footage that was left over, and which is what happened really. You know, we had guys like Dane and Kelly and Shane and like Kalani all come through, and it was like they didn't fit into The Drifter anywhere. It just didn't really make sense in the story that we were going on, and so it was like, man, it just seems like a waste to like have all this great footage of these guys and with such an amazing camera and the whole setup. So we went through and found all those sessions.
The result is Rob's latest film, Melali, The Drifter Sessions.
It's definitely not the plug in, get amped, I wanna go do, you know, shove it and air reverses. There's none of that. Although Dane does, you know, he busts a few errors in the movie. I don't. I just think it's beautiful. Like, it's shot really beautifully, and you know, with a red camera, it just like it pops.
While The Drifter was a major production, for Rob, Melali became deeply personal, which is why he got ultra involved in the sounds behind the film.
It stemmed from doing the Drifter tours. From doing the tours and playing music on those tours, we kind of came up with this idea of like, let's put together this new movie and score it. Playing live, a live score to an audience, to the film, is like something that's just so, like, we've done it a couple times now and it's amazing. Taylor started putting together the movie and he created these sessions and he sent them over to us, and I got John Swift involved in the project, and then Todd Hannigan and Fernando Apodaca.
For the musicians, it was a reunion of sorts.
John, we kind of, I mean, he was in my first movie, Drifting, in 97. He had a couple tunes in there, and then I think Shelter was where all three of those guys really came in. I know Todd and Fernie, they scored something for that. John had a couple tracks in there. And since then, everyone's music career's kind of grown and grown, so now it's like everyone's kind of got their own little shindig going. We're just kind of pooling everyone together for this little project, which is super cool, because all amazing musicians. So John kind of took the lead role. He was kind of the director, and we locked him in a barn out here in Olivenhane, and he just started recording ideas, and we would come in all at separate times together and just start throwing stuff around and like watching footage and like playing stuff to the footage, and then we'd get the length right and then re-edit the footage to the music, and it was kind of like this constant evolution.
In the end, the beauty of Melali is the simplicity of its message.
And you get a real feel that you're like watching a complete session of a guy or a couple guys, a couple friends. So it kind of just gives you that, like, I don't know, it's what we all kind of strive for as surfers, I think. It's like, that's what's great. It's like, let's go find a wave and surf, just us.